We're back with our friend Bill Maher. Bill, as I said, tomorrow, Friday, you've got a show live, real time.
Yeah, I'm glad you reminded me. I got to leave.
Exactly. Just wait a few more minutes, please.
All right. I'm sorry.
What are your thoughts on what has happened last week? It was one of the sort of the saddest weeks on memory, you know, given a chain of many sad weeks we've had in this country and around the world.
Right.
Do you have any reflections on on what happened last week?
On both sides of it. I mean, first of all, you know, I'm a bit of a cynic. I think civilization is a mile wide and an inch deep. Without the police on the job, you know that movie The Purge? Mm-hmm. It'd be that every day. Without the police.
Oh, I believe that there should be like a social order and there should be some authority.
Right, and without it, you know, I mean...
Not an anarchist.
In 2 days, you would eat my liver. And it wouldn't be good for you. Okay. So, obviously, anytime anybody shoots a policeman, you know, it's just abhorrent. And, you know, there's no and, ifs, or buts about it. So, I don't condone it, but I understand it. I mean, you can only look at so many videos of shooting unarmed black people. I'm surprised it actually didn't happen before. Mm-hmm. So
Kennedy said, you know, famously, that those who make peaceful revolution impossible make violent revolution inevitable.
Right.
And the Black Lives Matter movement is trying to raise awareness of the fact that this has been going on for a long time, and it comes, it's paid attention to, and then it passes.
This goes back to, well, certainly before, but on tape, Rodney King. Mm-hmm. Rodney King was, what, 1991, 92, something like that? Mm-hmm. I mean, we all looked at that tape and we thought, oh, how can these cops get away with this? You know, I mean, no matter what Rodney King did, lead them on a chase, they got him on the ground and the six guys just wailing on him with the baton and somehow he gets off. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's something wrong here that has to be addressed. So obviously violence is wrong on both sides. But, you know, I've been talking about police culture in this country for a long time. Like I say, we all need the police. I think we respect them. But there is something wrong with police culture. And I don't think most policemen are bad people at all, and I don't think most policemen would do the things we see on tape. But there is that thin blue line mentality where they protect their own. And I think that has to change.
Do you think it's worse than it used to be? Or do you think that we just get to see some of the abuses of authority now?
Well, that's true, too. We see it more. But I certainly don't think it's any better. I think we just see it. And I think the police, kind of like the priesthood, they attract the wrong kind of people sometimes. Sorry.
It's all right.
But it's kind of true. You know, I mean, I think there's a lot of people who go into police work because they were the person who, when they were young, they had no authority, they were kind of losers, and now they want to have the ability to lord it over people, you know? The police department cannot be revenge for high school. And we have to weed out...
You're speaking of a few people, or are you sort of painting with a broad brush there?
We don't know. We don't know, but certainly, I mean, I've seen enough videos to know that there are too many cops who act like that. I mean, any is too many. Mm-hmm. And yes, I do think that's a type of person who goes into police work. And by the way, you can eliminate that. There are psychology tests that you can take. Why do you want to be a policeman? I think most policemen want to do it for the right reasons, and I think most do it for the right reasons. But I also think that, you know, when they say it's a difficult job, it is a difficult job that you volunteered for. You know, no one is conscripted into police work. You wanted to do it. It's dangerous, yes, but it says to protect and serve on the side of the card that refers to us you're protecting and serving. You're not there to protect yourself.
But that doesn't diminish in any way the tragedy of what happened last week.
Did I say it does?
No, but but the implication of that, when I hear that, is that you have to expect that that is going to happen sometimes.
No, I didn't say that either. I said I'm surprised that it hasn't happened before. You cannot shoot unarmed people continually without someone firing back. Sorry, that's just the way it is. And I hope it gets better in this country. It should get better. And I don't want to see any more violence. But yes, I do think police culture has to change to a degree. It's only been recently when we saw these horrific shootings, and only recently that they've even said, well, you know, this was wrong. Before that, it was always, they were doing it by the book. By the book? Well, maybe you need a new book.
There is some sense.
So the funny
earlier,
part of the show was over. We didn't...
Oh, this is all being edited out. None of this is going to make it to air, Bill. We're going to stick with the Pokemon jokes for all of this. So, you know, what you said earlier is that it's happening on both sides. Do you think there's a way that it doesn't end up being sides? That there could be a cessation of a sense that there is a side, and that you have to be on one side or the other side? Because I think that leads to another era of hostility.
It shouldn't be sides. Mm-hmm. But it does have to start with the police stop shooting unarmed black people. And the police stop going for the gun immediately. Mm-hmm. Again, it is a dangerous job. I'm sorry it is, but you volunteered for it. It's like a proctologist getting to the office and going, oh my God, I can't believe I'm looking at ass all day. Well, when you're a cop, you're going to be looking at ass all day. That is the job you signed up for. Mm-hmm. And the first time you're a little nervous, you can't just bam, 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 mm-hmm. so I don't get hurt. And again, I don't think most cops do that.
Do you think they're trained into this behavior?
I don't think they're trained enough or well enough. I don't. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've seen police shootings where they fired, like, a lot of times, very close range, and didn't even hit the guy. Spend some time at the range.
Or be a stormtrooper.
You know, I think what happened in this country is that in the late 60s, people called the cops pigs, which was very, very wrong. That was the mentality. And ever since then, we've kind of been trying to make up for that. And we put them on a pedestal. You know, you can't criticize, you can't say anything, they're always heroes. Well, they often are heroes, but they're also human beings who are doing a human job. And again, most of them, I think, like their job because, yes, you see some of the disrespect, and sometimes they are disrespected, but to be a cop is also to have a lot of perks. A lot of people kissing your ass, a lot of free donuts, a lot of free stuff, you know? Mm-hmm. And that's fine, but that's the job, and I think most of them would want to keep doing it.
It's not a job that I would want to do.
But that's why you didn't go into it. And they don't want your job.
They might. It's a nice job. I don't know who wouldn't want this job. It's a pretty nice job.
Yeah, you know what?
I sit here, I talk to you. Yeah, they pay me a lot of money. I was just drinking.
You're right. I take that back. They'd love to have your job.
Mm-hmm. They'd love to have your job, too.
Yeah, they would love to have
mine. Yours is once a week. That sounds really easy.
It's actually not. Because I have to make it good. Anyway,
Would you like
it? I'm good. Thank you.
Real time airs Fridays on HBO, and check out special convention episodes over the next couple of weeks. Bill Maher, everybody. Bill, thank you so much for being here.